Hey, what's up? I'm Eric here. Today's project is about BLE secure server that supports multi-client. Usually, I'm developing mobile applications that are linked to hardware. Sometimes there are some issues when communicating BLE on mobile. Also, the operation of BLE in iOS and Android is different, so we need to pay attention when implementing it. This video introduces you to a system where ESP32 becomes a BLE server, iOS and Android become a client and receive data from the server if they have a correct PIN code. The content of the BLE is huge, so it only describes the security part. Okay, let's get started. Here is a simple scenario. I'm gonna make a secure BLE server that can be used on not only Android but also iPhone. When connecting to the BLE server from mobile, the PIN number must be entered and the PIN number must be correct to connect from the server and get data. If the correct PIN number is not entered, the connection is lost and no more data is received or sent. The reason why we need this approach is that sometimes we need to communicate with clients who have a key. For example, my smartwatch should only be able to connect to my phone. Also, let's say you make a commercial product. It must be connected to only a specific app. Let's see how we can do. Here is a project code. The source code is available from my GitHub repository. The link is down below in the description. Use the previous project, the bearer indicator, to represent bearer information. Please refer to the video above for the bearer indicator if you need it. The code is simpler than with the because many parts are omitted. In addition, the BLE server part is not much different from the BLE multi-client example source code we normally use, except the security part. So I focus on explaining the BLE security part. The rest of the parts are all related to the bearer indicator, so you don't need to worry about this. To get more detailed information about Bluetooth in ESP32, you need to see the source code made of ESP-IDF. You can check everything from the detailed settings of Bluetooth to how it works. The screen you are seeing now is a GATT secure server example source code. The source code allows you to print to the console log for every step so that you know what process is currently in progress. This is possible because all event handlers are registered. If you need detailed settings, please refer to this. If you go to the bottom, you can see the app main. Here's where you set up BLE security. If you modify only this one, it allows a mobile to enter a PIN number. Let me show you how it works shortly. I will explain the security part while leaving the Arduino code. This is just to show that everything came from here. Okay, let me build it and show you the console log. On the right, it shows all the logs from the Bluetooth. It says that all regionalization has been completed and the advertisement has started. Let me find ESP-BLE security on the iPhone and connect it. My iPhone is mirrored on the left. Here we are. There is a Bluetooth pairing request. I'm entering the PIN number, but you can see it, right? This is because iPhone doesn't allow me to record all passwords on the screen. It's really secure. Anyway, on the console, it says the pair status is success. Good. It's connected and I can read the data from the BLE server. Let's disconnect it. GATT disconnect event occurs. The advertising starts again. This is the overall process in the secure server. Currently, this code doesn't support multi-client. Let's go back to the Arduino and how we can make our own BLE secure server for multi-connection. Let's go to the BLE part. When initializing BLE, put the desired BLE device name together. This will be the name of the device that is shown on other devices. Setting the encryption level with ESP-BLE Security Encrypt. It's required in the authentication process to provide this prime input passkey. Set the security callback here. Security callback created by inheriting from the class BLE security callbacks. In my opinion, only on security request and on authentication complete are needed. If the passkey matches, A CMPR, which is the authentication complete indication, is successful. Other cases include incorrect passcode and timeout. The following creates a server from the BLE device and specifies a server callback. The server callback can confirm that the client is connected and disconnected. Register services for the data communication. You can create multiple services and multiple characteristics. If you want to know more details, please look at the GATT part. It defines a way that two Bluetooth LE devices transfer data back and forth using concepts called services and characteristics. Specifies the access permission for the characteristic service that sends and receives data. Encrypts both read and write. Currently, we use it as a BLE server and we need to start advertising because we are in the position of the being accessed by other devices. And it works as a peripheral device. The following are security settings. This part brought the source code of the previous ESP-IDF. If you look at the functions code at the bottom, they are all settings the security of gap. Gap is what makes your device visible to the outside world and determines how two devices interact with each other. The first setting is the passkey. I already defined the passkey above. My passkey is 999999. Set the authentication requirements of the local device. This option means bonding with the peer device after authentication. This will allow previously bonded connections to bypass the gap layer and stop all new connections. Set our device IO capability to read end user perform authorization either by displaying or entering generated 6-digit PIN code. There are 5 options. Display only, display yes, no, keyboard only, no input, no output, and keyboard display. In the passkey mode, the display only option worked well. If you need to have a different input, please try other options. Set the maximum encryption key size to support. It said it should be between 7 and 16. Set the authentication option here. Disable the accept only specified SMP authentication requirement. SMP will authenticate the client by applying the specified authentication providers. This BLE device is currently operating as a slave, which is advertising and waiting for clients. So this device needs to get the type of the init key from the clients, which is a master, and the response key means which key you can distribute to the client. Let's see how the callback function works. Server callback and security callback will be registered. It's very simple because it only has two callbacks. Attempting to pair with the server on client mobile. First, it's connected and receives a passkey from the client. Determine if the entered passkey is okay or not. If the passkey is correct, keep connecting, otherwise disconnect the client. This is how the ESP32 BLE server works. Once the client accesses the server, it's no longer advertised. In order to support multi-client, I made the advertisement start again as soon as security callback is over. There is one problem. The operation of the BLE between the iPhone and Android is a little bit different. For Android, if the passkey is not correct, it's disconnected immediately. While on iPhones, the connection is maintained and getting data even if the passkey is wrong. It made me crazy. Unfortunately, I couldn't find a perfect solution for iOS. The method I found is at least not to send data to the client if the passkey is not correct. In a security callback, if authentication is unsuccessful, I forcibly remove the current device from the peer devices. This does not mean disconnecting the client. It's just removing the client from the roster. Let me show you the result. Connect and enter the wrong passkey. It's connected and let's look at the notifying data. This time, we can see that there are no updated values. This is the best for now. I will update it if I find a better solution. Reviewing the rest of my code before we finish, the code I made is working with two tasks. One is the battery indicator that we created before, and the other one is notifying data if there are clients connected from BLE and displays the number of the clients connected to the screen. Both tasks are updating the screen. In this case, to avoid problems, we should prevent the start of one task while it's in progress. Using the semaphore object, we make the two tasks work alternatively. If I have a chance, I'd like to talk about this again. That's all for today's project. I hope this video was helpful for your project. Please leave your comment if you have a good idea. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.